Hello, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. Okay, recently I love playing with this device very much. I've been wishing there was an ESP32 development board with a form factor similar to the Nest device. It's because I thought it would make various projects possible, not just the home assistant project. The features of round displays and the use of magnetic encoders are enough to bring new ideas, so it's super exciting. The most interesting part of this device is the magnetic encoder. Of course, I think it's difficult for this magnetic encoder to replace the touchscreen, I know that. However, I don't think it's a big deal, because it's still possible to receive input from a magnetic encoder and handle without a touchscreen. Nevertheless, it would be more fun if it could be done with a touchscreen as well, so I'm looking forward to the next version of this product. Today, I'm going to talk about the magnetic encoder that this device has. A magnetic encoder detects changes in a magnetic object as it passes the sensor. It can know the speed and direction. It has a mechanical part and analog feeling, so I like it. Let's take a look at the device I prepared. The value read from the encoder is displayed at 360 degrees, and below is the count information obtained from the sensor, so this is the raw value. Through this, we can see the current degree of rotation and it's counting properly without missing anything even in a fast rotation. To represent 360 degrees, the counting value from the sensor is multiplied by 4. The reason I did this is that I wanted to know the absolute rotation value. I will put a red circle here where 0 degree points. This makes it easier to check now. Now let me turn it around. The number of revolutions calculated from the encoder is 90. Then to represent 360 degrees based on this number of rotations, multiply by 4. Unfortunately, this is obviously not a good solution. The magnetic encoder must have an accurate number of revolutions through accurate sensing. If it misses even one rotation, you won't know the exact absolute rotation. For this reason, there is a huge gap in the price difference between magnetic encoder sensors. There is also an expensive sensor which is a 14-bit angular rotation sensor that can measure up to 25,000 RPM. Let's take apart the inside of the device. I wonder how the magnetic encoder is installed. The other parts will pass quickly. Probably made it as simple as possible to lower the production cost. Alright, we are here. The encoder used in this device is Dual Hall Effect Latch IC. The model is MT8901. Two hole pipes exist inside this sensor. They are placed at a fixed spacing of 1.45 mm between the sensing elements. The first hole plate provides the speed signal output. The combination of both the hole plate signals is then internally processed to deliver a direction signal output. A magnetic ring is attached to this handle, so it can calculate direction and speed when it's turning. Now let's take a magnet and rub it directly over the sensor. Will it respond really well? Before that, I will connect the display so that we can see the value from the encoder. A magnet is ready. Let's go back and forth on the sensor IC with this. You can see the magnetic encoder responding. When passing from top to bottom, a clockwise direction is read. I believe it's from left to right, which is H1 to H2 plate. What about the code for this? It's using pulse counter to count the number of the rising and falling edges of the input signal from the encoder. The peak counter is duplicated, so you have to use pulse counter instead. Everything is very straightforward. Set the minimum and maximum value of the pulse count first. Specify the GPIO numbers used by edge type signal and level type signal. Set specific actions for the rising and falling edge of the signal. So it's set to decrease the counter on the rising edge and increase the counter on the falling edge. Set specific actions for high and low level of the signal. Keep the counting mode when the control signal is high level and reverse the counting mode when the control signal is low level. The last step is to set the glitch filter. If a signal pulse width is smaller than this value, then it will be treated as noise and won't increase and decrease the internal counter. That's it. It's a source code to initialize the pulse counter to get a counter value from the magnetic encoder. Today we looked at the operation of the magnetic encoder, which is the core of this device. It seems that we can make our own smart knob using Hall effect IC and 3D printer. I hope this video would be helpful for your project. Thanks for watching, then see you in the next video.